The following show is a paid program.
What's up? I am so excited today. One of my favorite gospel singers is with us on today. She's an evangelist, an accomplished national recording artist, minister of music, songwriter, producer, and community activist, Kathy Taylor. Hey, lady, how you doing?
Hello. I'm so glad to be with you today. Yes.
I tell you today, I couldn't even sleep last night. I've been up since 4.
Oh, my goodness.
I was so excited to see you and be here with you because every time I go to Windsor Village, I always ask before I even go, I call them. I know they say, who is this guy calling? I call to see if Kathy is going to sing one of my favorite songs. You will be so surprised what it is. So let's see it, guys. Let's see one of my favorite songs, and let's see Kathy in action. That's it.
Hello.
That is.
his
precious is his name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. How did we get here, Kathy? How did you start singing? I saw in here it says Kathy began her recording career as a soloist with the legendary James Cleveland Gospel Music of America. How did you get there?
Well, you know, my mother was the minister of music at our church coming up.
Yes.
And, you know, of course, if you were her child, you were going to be in the choir. So I started leading songs around the age of 7 or 8.
Mm-hmm.
And had the opportunity. In fact, your guest for tomorrow invited me to the Gospel Music Workshop to sing one of his songs.
And right.
That's how I got started.
Wow. Oh, my God. And then to be at Windsor Village, and then to be minister of music. Wow. Look at how many people. Jesus.
Yes. You know, God has a way of putting you in the right place at the right time to do the things he's called you to do, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe that, you know. I believe I was called to Windsor Village, and I also believe that I'm called to the world to sing this news of Jesus Christ.
I love that. I love the fact that you've dedicated now your life, your whole life to the music.
Yes.
Wow.
It's all I know.
Exactly.
Yes.
I love that part about you. And you talk so candidly about music and how people, and you've helped so many local artists become national artists, you know, mainstream. How does that happen? Because so many that are in the choir many times say, I want to do exactly that.
Yes. Well, you know what? I can't say, I hope that something I've done helped some of them to get to mainstream, you know.
Yes.
I can't take the credit for it. God has a way of just doing what he does.
Right.
So if I expose them to something, if I, you know, I tried to do CDs with the church so that they could get their foot in the door and also get some experience recording, you know, so that was kind of my goal, is just to help to make a platform.
I love that. We were talking to Angela Bennett on yesterday, and she was talking about the Houston Alliance Gospel Music Professionals and the organization. And she mentioned your name and how you helped so many people along the way and give information. And that's how you do, Kathy. I've known you. I've seen you. Along the way, I've been watching you, and you have given so many people information that they didn't have to pay for. Information.
Well, you know, I believe that, you know, there are seasons in life.
Yes.
And, you know, sometimes there's a season where you're to share and you're to mentor. You're to, we got to reach back. You know, we can't just, you know, so it's important to me to hit all those marks, because, you know, truly, I want to be all called me to be.
Absolutely.
You know, so if there's, Angela is one of our choir members in the choir.
Yes.
So, and, you know, she is an outstanding singer. Brian Courtney Wilson has been in our choir.
Yes.
You know, so we're just excited about what God is doing in the kingdom of God.
Yes.
You know, not just our house, but the kingdom of God. We're just excited.
And I'm glad we're mentioning that. On this morning, there was a video and you were talking about family in COVID-19. It was so phenomenal. Just a little bit about the singing, you and your husband singing and things like that. Let's talk about the realness of COVID, because people don't think it's real. They don't.
Well, let me just say this. We have, my whole family have been staying home since March.
Yes.
COVID hit our household. I got it first. I didn't know I had it. So it spread to my entire family.
Wow.
So the clip that you saw this morning was really our attempt to, you know, let our people know that it is real.
Yes.
And some of the tools and some of the keys that helped us get through it. Because I am so happy to say today, God brought us all out.
Right. Let's talk about some of those that you were giving out.
Well, okay. So let me set this up for you. Like, I was in the hospital with it for 9 days.
Oh,
And
my
but
God.
my husband was home, our nanny was home, and our children were home. One of the now the children never our children never had any symptoms.
Right.
They were running, playing like always. But like one of the main things that helped me is laying on your stomach. You know, because some way it extends your lung capacity, and it helps your lungs to work at a, you know, at a better rate. So that's one of the things I know that really, when I first got to the hospital, that's what the doctor said, lay on your stomach. And I think I was on my stomach around 36 hours the first time, you know, trying to, because my symptom was I couldn't hardly breathe.
Right, right.
It was respiratory. Yeah.
Right.
And so I would call home and tell my husband, lay on your stomach, tell everybody, lay on your stomach or whatever, you know.
Right.
Just trying to navigate through it. And that just lets me know, it just assured me even more of how powerful God is, you know.
Yes.
When I look back on it, I had the least pre-underlining conditions. If somebody was going to go that far, it's, you know, I'm glad it was me, because I'm not sure if, you know, the others would have made it through it.
Right.
As well as I did, you know.
Yes.
But yes, that's one of the things we say. And then also wash your hands.
Yes.
And wear your mask.
Mm-hmm. You
know, it's just the simple things that will help you, you know. And then if you have it, drink hot stuff as much as you can. You know, like I did hot lemon and water.
Mm-hmm.
It goes a long way on helping you recover. Now these, and I'm just saying the tips, I'm not saying I'm a doctor or
right.
No, am I telling right. you to do this?
Right.
Go to your doctor, follow
right.
his instructions.
Right.
But I'm just telling you, these are some of the things that helped me
yes.
along and help my family. And I just thank God today
yes.
that we are all COVID free.
Absolutely. And I'm so glad that you brought that up. And I'm so glad it happened this morning that I was seeing it, because of the fact we need to tell our family
yes.
how real it is, because I still
and, you know,
see so many not wearing the mask.
And also, you know, some people who have had it or who has it, they feel ashamed because
yes.
they have it, you know. And it's so easy, because you would be surprised how I call it. I mean, I've been home since March. So
right.
I mean, yeah, so it can happen in a...
Right.
A moment.
Absolutely.
One sneeze.
Yes.
You know, one sneeze, one cough, you
mm-hmm.
know. You know, just so you can touch the faucet behind somebody who had it. It's,
right.
It's very easy to catch.
Right,
and
right,
so
right.
I'm just asking you to wear your mask and continuously wash your hands.
Absolutely. I'm so glad you said that. Also, I'm glad you are transparent in speaking
yes.
about it. They also said being in the hospital, because you're alone. Many people are alone
yeah.
by themselves. So mentally, you have
yes.
to be, you know what I mean? That's a
well,
big part of it.
Well, I know. For me, I was in the hospital 9 days. But you know, I tell you, I thought it was 4 days until I was walking out of the hospital.
Wow.
I just thought it was 4 days. And for me, yes, you're isolated. But, you know, I kept an underline of praise and worship going in my room.
Right.
And I had some wonderful time with God. And
yes.
He just really took me through it, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm just so grateful. That's how I made it through it.
Yeah.
You know, so I just want to encourage anybody, don't be discouraged. Put you some praise and worship music on and watch God do what he does.
Absolutely. 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 We're going to take a break and we'll be right back with Kathy Taylor.
We'll be right back to the Cam Hill Show after these messages.
Houston's only Cadillac to your door dealer, Ron Carter Cadillac, delivers test drives to your home or office. For a limited time, get $16,000 off all in-stock Cadillac 2019 XT5 crossovers and $19,000 off all in-stock 2019 CT6 sedans. Or experience the first ever 2020 Cadillac XT6 Premium Luxury Collection, only $519 with $1 down for 39 months lease. Or purchase and receive 0.9% APR for 72 months with no payments until November. RonCarterCadillac.com.
it comes to protecting yourself and your partners, all the information out there can be overwhelming. Visit our website. We are a free and confidential service, striving to help you stay informed and stay notified. We are committed to a healthy Houston.
Houston's only Cadillac to your door dealer, Ron Carter Cadillac, delivers test drives to your home or office. Drive the new 2020 Cadillac XT4, only $399 a month, or the new 2020 XT5, only $429 a month, both for 39 months lease with just $1 down. Or purchase the XT4 or XT5 and enjoy 0.9% APR for 72 months with no payments until November. RonCarterCadillac.com.
Have you been injured in an 18-wheeler accident, truck accident, car accident? Was someone texting and ran into the back of you, not paying attention? It doesn't matter what it is. Give me a call. Attorney Willie Piles. We'll fix it today. The number is 281-881-2457. Again, that number is 281-881-2457. We'll fix it today. Call Attorney Willie Piles.
And now back to the Cam Hill Show.
Hey, family, we are back with evangelist Kathy Taylor.
Yes, I'm so glad to be here.
Oh, absolutely. We're going to see the video that I was just speaking about when you were talking with your husband. You all were singing together. Let's show that one.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
No, he doesn't sing. He doesn't sing.
You were doing the singing.
It's fine, you see. Come on. Yet not distressed. Perplexed, but not in despair. I've got a treasure from the Lord.
All right. Give me some.
There you go. They are an awesome couple, dynamic duo.
Thank you so much.
Oh my God.
Yes, we were just talking about, we wanted to share with our community, you know, the importance of taking care of yourself.
Yes.
And staying home, staying out of crowds.
Yes.
During this COVID season.
Yes. I also want to touch on another thing that you do, adoption. You have two girls.
Yes, I do. My husband and I adopted two beautiful girls about 5 years ago.
Yeah.
So yes, it's been a blessing to us. It's so many of our kids in need of homes and mm-hmm. parents. And I just want to encourage anybody who feels really called to it, but it is truly a calling, you know?
Right.
You know, God bless us with just two beautiful girls.
Mm-hmm.
And one of our girls is on the autism spectrum, you know, which is a whole nother thing, but
yes.
We are just honored and blessed to serve God in this way.
Absolutely. I'm so glad about that. I love the way that you're an advocate now for adoption for African Americans.
Yes, and also Autism Speaks. I always,
yes.
You know, throwing a plug for them as well. They're doing so much to help people and parents with yeah. autistic children, you know how to cope and also get the information on all the stuff that's available to you.
Yes.
With that. So it's important. A lot of us just don't have the information. You know?
Right.
And sometimes, you know, you think you may be a certain age so you can't adopt. Or
mm-hmm.
You're not at a certain financial quote so you can't adopt. It's all kind of help out there. If you feel led to adopt, just get the information on that as well.
Mm-hmm. I love the way that you speak about adoption in the fact that and you're very transparent of what you go through, how they come into the home at any time.
Yes. But you know, some people in this world is so sick that they have to, you know, they have to go extra
right.
measures, you know, just because this world today,
yeah.
you know, people But God, we need to get on the, we really need to get on the wall.
Yes.
And the more kids we keep in the adoption center and in foster care,
yes,
the more trouble we're going to have. We have to take care of our own.
Yeah.
And bring them up in the ways of Christ, you know?
Absolutely.
And so many feel like they don't have anybody or are feeling alone. And so you have adults who are missing so many things. So their integrity level,
yes,
what they'll do, they don't care because
right,
they've not had that initial foundation.
Right.
And that's, you know, that's, and that's our job. You know, if, you know, when I was coming up, it was two or three extra children in a whole bunch of households. You know, we were just taking care of our own. They may
right,
have been a niece or, you know, and nowadays we don't care.
We don't. We don't have
the
village anymore. Yeah, we don't have that village anymore.
That's right. And it's time for us to get back to the basics. I
yes,
believe some of that is why we are sitting at home right now with COVID.
Yeah.
God is trying to tell us something.
Yes. Yes, absolutely. Because everybody is sitting at home. No matter
yes,
if you rich or if you poor.
There you go. There you are. Yes.
And yeah, I
and everybody could do more for God. I'm not landing on one person. Everybody
right,
could do more for God. And while we're in this season, let's just get right with God. That's
yeah,
what I'm saying.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I truly, truly agree with you on that. And you, like I said, you're an advocate for adoption because you speak so highly of it and how you started. You started as a foster parent.
Yes, I did.
Mm-hmm.
I just was trying to help too. I was trying to help a lady who
yes,
had, yeah, that's what I was trying to do. But, you know, God knew what he was doing.
Right.
And I'm so grateful. I'm so much better because I did what he called me to do.
I love that about you, that you did step out in the transparency and helping other people just to understand that we have to help our own. Because these
we
children,
have-
yeah, these children are in foster care. And once they get to 18, they just
they're lost.
They just throw them out. They just
that's
let them just on the street.
And think about it. I came up in a two-parent home. My dad died young when I was young,
mm-hmm,
but I came up with a mother and a big support system. At 18, I was not ready to
exactly,
go
exactly, exactly, exactly.
You know,
exactly.
Yes.
At 18, throw some of our children out at 18, and we've been
thank you
paying for everything. They've been lost.
<That's it. laughs> Yes, you know.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah, we have to, you know, and if you got a little home, that's all right. If you got an apartment,
mm-hmm,
whatever you have, somebody will be grateful for it. And I'm not saying they are kids now.
Yes.
You know, do what children do.
Yes.
You know.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm so fulfilled doing it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. The other part of it that I've seen George Floyd. Wow.
Yes.
Wow. And the call that you did in singing at his funeral. Jesus, the impact that you held for the family. I've heard even family members saying, thank God for you for singing them through that, for helping them through that, because to even see him pass away, we all saw, the world saw.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes. Well, you know what? I want to first give a shout out to Nikita Fox.
Yes.
She recommended me be a part of that program,
mm-hmm,
and I'm so grateful to her. I was honored to be a part of the program, and, you know, and I just wanted to serve. And,
yes.
So the song God is with us,
mm-hmm,
sometimes the word says sometimes life can change suddenly.
Yes.
And you find it hard to even breathe.
Yes.
I wrote that song a year or so ago.
Wow.
But I'm finding it to be so appropriate in the world.
Right.
Today, you know, from the George Floyd thing, which was most unfortunate and most unfair.
Right.
To when I was in the hospital gasping for air because and needing help with an oxygen machine.
Yes.
You know, and then something else may have taken your breath away.
Yes. Yes.
But and so whatever that hour is and whatever that moment is, I just want you to remember
mm-hmm,
that God He is with us.
Wow.
You can be of good courage and be assured that God is with you. Mm-hmm. And because the scripture goes on to say, I will not leave you, nor will I forsake you. So that's what we got to remember, even in these times of social injustice, in these times where our land is in need of a healing. We got to stand tall in God is with us.
Wow.
And be of good courage.
Just knowing that, just truly knowing the meaning of what that is. Wow.
Yes.
Wow, wow. Guys, we have a clip of that one where God is with us.
And you find it hard to even breathe. So used to being strong, now I'm barely hanging on. Y'all, we gotta stand tall.
God is with us. Oh my God. How powerful that song is right now.
Praise God. Thank you.
That we are needing that at this moment. 40 million plus people are unemployed right this moment.
Yes.
Many people have not only been laid off, they're losing their homes because they can't pay for them. They're losing their cars because they can't pay for them. They are not even able to eat. They're having to go to pantries at this moment. And we're talking 2020. We're not talking 1820. We're talking in 2020, right this moment, that people and many of us have passed away without our family members being by our side.
Yes.
This COVID, I'm telling you, it's something. It's something.
But even without that, God is still.
That's it. That's it. The song in itself is so pertinent for now. It's a now. And thank you so much for it, for writing it and putting together. And it's your. This is your new single now.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Wow. How did it work out that it's now? You said it.
It's God. Yeah. It is so God.
Yeah, it's so Him. It's so Him. And I love the way you speak about Jesus and how you say His name. Miss Kathy Taylor, I tell you, when you say the name, it's just like it runs all through all of our bodies when we're in, you know, praise and worship.
Yeah. Well, I got to tell you, I cannot take any credit for that. It's just the name. If you start calling over and over and over, it's power in the name.
Yeah.
It's just not me calling it, but it's power.
It is. It's power in the name. Isn't that so? Isn't that so? Some of the things that you will be doing going forward, let's talk about that.
Well, as you know, we're reconfiguring everything since this COVID. Right. I'm supposed to be in a play.
Yes.
I think it's put off to the beginning of the year.
Yes.
I'm asking everybody to please look out for it. And I'm certain that we'll be safe enough for you guys to come out to it.
Yeah.
I'm working on a CD. You should be hearing much more about that as the year goes on. And I'm just blessing the Lord everywhere I can while I can, you know.
Mm-hmm. 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 I love that. Shout out to Oscar Magar and Broken Vessel, the group, Soul Purpose. Yeah. Yes, that yes. will be, you are the lead in that play.
Well, I'm one of the leads.
What did you say? You're one of the leads.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I think it's going to be a great experience for me, as you know. Well, no, I've done one other play, but it was local. So this will be national. So
yes.
Pray for me as I embark upon this new play.
You will be just fine. You're going to do great. I already know that. Let's also talk about, we talked a little bit about the Houston Alliance Gospel Music Organization. Music Professionals. It's an organization. Angela Bennett on yesterday was speaking about it. She was the president. But let's give some benefits of what that organization is for local gospel artists trying to become or help.
I'll tell you what, the great thing about them, they have lots of information for you. That's one. And then they also are building a great platform for your work to be heard and seen.
Mm-hmm.
So the connection, you know, in this world, it's not even what you know anymore. It's all about who you.
Yes.
And that is a great organization to line up with. They can show you a lot of things that you save you a lot of heartache that you won't have to have it, because this group will really get behind you and help you succeed with your endeavor. And the great thing I love about them, they love everybody. You know, it's not like a crab mentality.
Right.
They want to see everybody win.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I love the fact that she was speaking about you have attorneys, because many times we don't read the contract.
That's right.
We have the craft, we have the showmanship, we know how to get up there and perform, but it's a business side of the music business. It's a major business side.
And people don't say it, it's 75% to 80%.
Yes. And then you see the difference in God-fearing people, too. You see a change. You see a change when money when money is involved. Yeah. Okay. You'll see a little change.
Absolutely.
You know? Yeah.
Absolutely.
You see you see the change in some people when the business, we'll be singing glory, and then all of a sudden when that money is trying to, it's changed.
That's right.
It's a difference.
Yeah,
yeah, it's a difference.
Change in who gets the glory.
I love it. I love it. It's true. That is so true. But as speaking of the business side, you help so many as well as others that have already gone the journey.
Yes. You know, the mistakes I made, I want to just keep others from making the same mistakes. You know, so I try to and still do just as much as I can, you know, share my knowledge. And let me just say this too. The music industry has changed so much now.
Yes.
But it's more accessible to you as an individual. So so you know, especially with all of this internet and social media, it's much easier to it's a hard road, but
it's easier. A little easier.
Yes.
Sounds good.
A lot of tools.
Absolutely. Let's take a break real quick, and we'll be right back with Cam.
We'll be right back to the Cam Hill Show after these messages.
When it comes to protecting yourself and your partners, all the information out there can be overwhelming. Visit our website. We are a free and confidential service, striving to help you stay informed and stay notified. We are committed to a healthy Houston.
Houston's only Cadillac to your door dealer, Ron Carter Cadillac, delivers test drives to your home or office. Drive the new 2020 Cadillac XT4, only $399 a month, or the new 2020 XT5, only $429 a month, both for 39 months lease with just $1 down. Or purchase the XT4 or XT5 and enjoy 0.9% APR for 72 months with no payments until November. RonCarterCadillac.com.
Have you been injured in an 18-wheeler accident, truck accident, car accident? Was someone texting and ran into the back of you, not paying attention? It doesn't matter what it is. Give me a call. Attorney Willie Powles. We'll fix it today. The number is 281-881-2457. Again, that number is 281-881-2457. We'll fix it today. Call Attorney Willie Powles.
Houston's only Cadillac to your door dealer, Ron Carter Cadillac, delivers test drives to your home or office. For a limited time, get $16,000 off all in-stock Cadillac 2019 XT5 crossovers and $19,000 off all in-stock 2019 CT6 sedans. Or experience the first ever 2020 Cadillac XT6 Premium Luxury Collection, only $519 with $1 down for 39 months lease. Or purchase and receive 0.9% APR for 72 months with no payments until November. RonCarterCadillac.com.
And now back to the Cam Hill Show.
Hey, family, we are back with Evangelist Kathy Taylor. Hey,
hello.
Lady. Hi, how you doing? Now that we look at church like it is, now it is more virtual.
Yes.
Virtual church. And many people are saying, there is a business side of church. And, uh-huh. and we have to let people know that the church is still there and it is still valuable. Let's talk a little bit about the value of still church, of church.
Well, let me just say this. We were in a meeting the other day at my church.
Yes.
Well, not my church, it's God's church, but it's
where I work.
And we were talking about all of the many ministries that we still have going on.
Right.
Even in the midst of COVID.
Yes.
And, you know, anything you do, you know, salvation is free.
Yes.
But to implement ministry, it just costs.
It costs.
You know, like right now we're doing a food bank at the Power Center every Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
And where we've given away over 400,000 meals and bags of groceries to people.
Wow.
We have, a lot of the Black-owned businesses are failing.
Yes.
So what we've done, what the pastor implemented was we have food trucks at the Power Center on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
You know, some of the food trucks are saying they have generated more funds than they have in a long time, even before COVID.
Right, right.
So, you know, our pastor is an entrepreneur and a businessman. That's just who he is.
Right.
And what he loves is seeing it working in the community.
Yes.
So that's one thing. That's two things that we're doing. But on the flip side of that, we have stuff for youth and children via Zoom. For the children, it's at 11:30 every day.
Wow.
Because you have so many children at home.
Yes.
And then so our church is just not a Sunday morning church.
Right.
You know,
right.
We try to give you good worship and a good word from God on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
But our senior citizens, they have a online session every Friday night. Well, they've had artists come on and sing, play instruments, to just talking about what's going on with our women's ministry, their meeting and having their Bible studies online. We've had the COVID testing up at, we've partnered with the NAACP and we're having COVID testing on our parking lot.
Wow.
At the church, you know, the list goes on and on. We have a back to school on Saturday normally we do a big back to school drive for our church.
Right.
But, you know, there are parents who have 3, 4, and 5 children at home going to school. So they don't have 3, 4, and 5 computers at home. So we're doing a back to school drive for the community.
Mm-hmm.
And so all of the monies and the funds that are raised will go to help children in be ready for school. See, they're going back to school. They're just not going back to the building,
mm-hmm.
but they're going back to school. So they need school supplies. And now on top of that, they need a computer.
They do. They do. And internet. And internet.
Yes, many and people, internet. So many people.
Many people don't have internet.
That's it. So, you know, so our church is thriving mm-hmm. and alive and well. You know,
yes.
We're doing, with the Worship and Arts Ministry, you know, some of our members, you know, just we meet every week on via Zoom
right.
to stay in touch with each other. But we also do tea parties. And
mm-hmm.
We learn how to bake a new pound cake. And mm-hmm. we all did it via Zoom, everybody in their own kitchen, just
right.
trying to stay connected. Trying
yes.
to, because, you know, being in the same place for a long time mentally,
yes.
sometimes it'll get you down. And then we all have all kind of counseling that we offer.
Good.
So the church is alive and well. We're doing a lot of the work from home.
Mm-hmm.
We're calling all of our members just
yes.
to say we love you and, mm-hmm. and stay connected with you. You know, so there's all kind of ministry going on. And because of that, ministry does cost.
Yes,
know?
It does.
We have to keep going. And,
yes.
You know, and the financial part of it, God just said, give 10%. What you're making, give 10%. You know, because like you said, there are a lot of people laid off now.
Yes.
You know, and we have to help them people, you know.
Right.
We can't just, you know, so, and then we have a big pool of that too. We are
yes.
helping a lot of people make it through this hard time, you know.
Yeah, definitely through this pandemic. Utilities,
yes.
people's utilities, you know.
Yeah.
They're paying rent, they're paying mortgage, all of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, all
so
of that.
We have a great church doing great ministry.
Yes.
For a great God.
I am so glad you're speaking on that. I'm so glad you've told about those things. Now, this Saturday, is the back to school this Saturday?
Yes, this Saturday is back to school, and you can go live. We're going live from Windsor Village.
Yes.
So you can go to kingdombuilders.com. That's our Facebook. Or you
yes.
can just go to the Windsor Village app, and it'll take you right to it.
Right, right, yeah. right. And then you were saying Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Are the trucks there? The food trucks?
Yeah, the food trucks are at the Power Center. And that's right on the corner of South Main and South Post Oak.
Yes, yes, yes. And we've got to support
you
them,
know, we
family.
You didn't say the name of my church. The name of my church is Windsor Village Church Family.
Yes.
And we'd love to have you. We're at 6011 West Orem Drive.
Yes.
We have church on Saturday nights at 6, 8, 10, and 12. You can log into the Windsor Village app, or you can go to kingdombuilders.com.
Yes.
And you can see us then.
Absolutely. I'm so glad you're saying that, because I'm
yes.
telling you, Windsor Village has been a staple. You all have been a staple in the community.
Yes.
Oh, my God, Pastor Kirby John and Suzette have been just
yeah.
a staple in the whole community,
right now,
the whole area.
Yeah. Like right now, we're getting ready to prepare communion for our members who are sick and shut in, and
yes.
elders.
Mm-hmm.
So like the elders who are able to drive and whatever, they're going to be able to come by and pick up their communion. We're going to box it up and just be there passing them.
Uh-huh.
And so as we're doing it on TV, they can go along with us. And then even, you know, and our church also is responsible for Corinthian Point, a home for 55 and up.
Yes.
A facility. So we'll be serving them as well.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we just have a plethora of things going on.
Right, right, right.
And I'm just excited to be a part of that.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm telling you, you all have done so much for Houston, not just for that area, but for Houston, Maine.
We are honored to serve.
Mm-hmm.
Honored to serve.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So let me
mm-hmm.
show a shout out to my beloved pastors, Kirby John and
yes.
Suzette Caldwell.
Mm-hmm.
We love you so much. And just the whole pastoral staff and the staff there, thank you for your support when I was ill. And also just that you do a fantastic job. And I just want to congratulate you personally.
Absolutely.
Give you a shout out.
Exactly, exactly. Let's do a shout out to your husband.
Okay. I want to throw a shout out to Thurman Outley for just being such a great husband and father. I look forward to what God is going to do through us. And mm-hmm. I want you to know I'm just godly proud of your ministry with Urban Boys. He runs a company called Mufasa's Pride.
Yes.
Their motto is making manhood mean more.
There you go. There you go. There you go. If somebody's interested in getting involved with that organization, how do they contact?
They can go to MufasasPride.com. Mm-hmm. They have a website, and mm-hmm. it's called Mufasas, MufasasPride, PRIDE.org.
Sounds good.
And they love to have it.
Also, you have a large following of people on Kathy Taylor Live. I know on Facebook, I'm one of the followers.
Yes. Well, thank you very much.
If you all want to see...
The other day, they said we have to grow it.
I'm telling you, if you want to see video, if you want to see taping, if you want to see a lot of things that are happening with Kathy Taylor, you go right on there, and she has a plethora of videos and just all type of pictures and everything. How did you start that?
Well, you know what? Not to tell my age, but I have a bunch of young people around me who's told me, Miss Kathy, you're going to have to get with it. In this day and time, social media is the way to go.
It is.
So I've just embraced it. Yeah. Because I want to be all God called me to be.
Yes.
You know, and sometimes it'll stretch you out of your comfort zone.
Yes.
You know, to other areas. So I am Kathy Taylor Live on all social media platforms.
Yes.
And if you think it's good now, you just wait. The best is still yet to come.
I love it. Yes. I love it. How can people purchase any of your CDs, especially this one right here, God Is With Us?
The whole CD is not out. The single is out. God is with us. You can get it on Apple Music, or you can go to my website, KathyTaylor.com, mm-hmm. and we'll send you an actual hard copy.
There you go. There you go. There you go. Yes. If people want to get in touch with you, are all the same social media? Let's talk about that.
Yes. Kathy Taylor, KathyTaylorLive.com. You can go, or you can... Kathy Taylor Live is all my social media as well. Mm-hmm. And you can just send a message and we'll get right back with you.
And that's true. They will.
My email address is KathyTaylorLive.com.
Mm-hmm. 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 What would you like to leave with the viewers?
I would just like to leave with the viewers, hey, stay encouraged. God is with you and he will not leave you, neither will he forsake you. Even if you're feeling alone right now, God is with you. Put you some praise music on. If you don't have anything to put a praise song on, just start humming one yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And you will feel God immediately come into the room. And I believe God with you right now, that you'll feel his presence and his power even now in the name of Jesus. Be blessed. Be safe. And I want to encourage you to love God with all your mind, your heart, and your soul. God bless.
Thank you so much, Miss Kathy Taylor. This has been great. I so appreciate you for the opportunity just to come with us, just on today, just to embark and tell people how good God is.
Yes, thank you so much for having me. I count it a privilege. There's a song that we've been singing a long time, and it's just as since I've been through so much, this just stuck with me, so I just want to send this out too. I'm sorry.
Yes.
You already asked me for my last. But what a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer.
Ooh. Thank you. Thank
what
you.
What a privilege.
Mm.
That's a privilege
mm-hmm.
we have to carry. Mm-hmm. We can take everything to God in prayer.
Thank you, Miss Kathy, for everything you're doing. God bless you. God keep you, and we love you. Know that.
Love you as well. God bless.
God bless. Bye-bye. Hey, guys, on tomorrow, you will see this guy in action, V. Michael McKay. I appreciate you. Love you. See you.